Good evening, brothers and sisters. Welcome to Immanuel Baptist Church, streaming live at the heart of Davao City, Philippines. And that, again, I would like to welcome you all to our midweek prayer meeting online. Kumusta na kamong tanan diha sa inyo mga panimalay? Kumusta po kayo dyan? At salamat for faithfully praying with us, no, as a church. And that salamat sa Panginoon dahil nakapagpatuloy tayo ngayon sa ating ano panalanginan. We would like to apologize sa yesterday, no, at talagang di kaya ng ano natin ng internet, no, connection. Kaya nga siguro talagang timely that our president included it, yung issue na yan, no, sa kanyang zona last Monday, ang pag-improve, no, sa mga internet connections, kasi nga talagang sobrang hina, okay, mabagal pa sa pagong. And that we would like to thank the Lord even today for opportunity that we can again meet together to worship the Lord. It's another day to praise Him, to worship Him, and even to offer our prayers to Him, to pray together as a family of God. And that there are many concerns that we would like to offer to the Lord ngayon sa panalangin, no? And that papanalangin po natin yung atin pong bansa, yung atin pong syudad, and even our church, and our families, and yun pong mga kailangan ipapanalangin po natin. So we really like to pray together, no, as a family. At let's be excited, no, as we come to the presence of the Lord to pray and to worship Him, no, tonight. Alam niyo, last 2 days ago, I read an article about a vaccine, no, sa COVID-19, that it's on its way, and it will be made before the year would end. At meron na daw vaccine na papalabas, no, before the year of before this year will end. And that sabi ko nga, wow, no, it's really ano God's blessing na kung meron talaga, meron ng ano itong, kung totoo talaga itong news na to, it's really a great news to hear. But even if it's not true, no, at patuloy pa rin tayong umasa, no, at manalig sa ating Panginoon, to trust in Him, to trust Him that He is the sovereign God, who knows, and He knows how to stop this COVID-19. And that wala pong imposible sa Panginoon. Amen. Sabi nga dito sa Luke chapter 19, verse 26, Jesus says, He looked at them and He said, "With men, this is impossible, but with God, all things are possible." No? Say with me again, with God, all things are possible. Walay imposible sa ato ang Ginoo, posible tanan, no? Even this pandemic, at alam natin na may purpose lang ang Panginoon itong lahat, may mensahe ang Panginoon sa ating lahat, and that let's just go sail along with the leading of God to us in this uncertain times. Let us come to the Lord this evening and let us start this meeting with a word of prayer. Let us pray. Panginoon, we believe that nothing is impossible with you, Lord. Nothing is too hard for you. That's why we, your people, have chosen to come together tonight to seek for your covering, to seek for your protection, and Lord, to call upon you for deliverance. Salamat po, Panginoon, sa iyo pong awa, Panginoon. Thank you for your mercy and your grace. Lord, we continue to seek you, O God, for hope. Panginoon, salamat, Panginoon, na ikaw po ang amin pong pag-asa sa lahat ng pangyayari po sa aming buhay. And that you are there, Lord, working in us, in our lives, and that you never leave us nor forsake us. Salamat po, Panginoon, for your assurance that you are with us, O God, even in times of this uncertain times. May your presence, Lord, go with us tonight as we worship you, as we go along with praying for one another, praying for the church, for the nation, and for the world, because we do believe, O God, that the prayer of the righteous is powerful and effective. Panginoon, we just submit, O God, Lord, to your word, to your presence tonight. May you guide us. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Friends, let us worship the Lord with this song, When I Look Into Your Holiness. Praise God for that very inspiring song, no? Sabi nga doon, the reason we live, the reason I live is to worship you. That's really yung goal ng ating buhay, no? Pagdating natin doon sa langit, just worshiping the Lord all the days of our lives, no? eternal, eternity, tayo ay mag-worship po sa Panginoon doon. And that we would like to welcome yung ating mga kasamahan who just tune in to our midweek prayer service. Welcome to our midweek prayer service. And that if you have any prayer concerns, just type in the comments dyan po sa ating ano, so that we could pray for you tonight. Okay? So, let us now move on to our meditation from the Word of God. And that our text is taken on the book of Matthew chapter 5, verses 23 to 24. Let us read the passage here and in Matthew chapter 5, verses 23 to 24. So if you are presenting a sacrifice at the altar in the temple and you suddenly remember that someone has against you, leave your sacrifice there at the altar. Go and be reconciled to that person, then come and offer your sacrifice to God. May the Lord bless the reading of His word. The message, the title of my message for tonight is entitled Worship That Pleases God. And that dito po tayo focus ngayon about the kind of worship that pleases God. And let us see in this text what does it tells us. Although it's very short, it's very understandable, no, itong passage, but let us expound this, what it really, why is it really important. And that makikita natin dito sa chapter 5, verses 23 to 24, this is the continuous teaching of Jesus Christ on the Sermon on the Mount of Beatitudes. So in this chapter, we have seen Jesus Christ teaching the crowds, the followers, and even His disciples on concerning the kingdom values that a disciple should live. No, tinuturuan po ni Jesucristo ang mga lahat ng mga audience niya na nandoon, including His disciples, on how a disciple should live these kingdom values na kailangan nilang ipamuhay. And that this teaching was actually part of the serious teaching on the Beatitudes. So tonight we will be studying on we will talk about the beatitude of the disciples should like while in the place of worship. Okay, what should be our attitude like while we are worshiping the Lord? No, ano ang mga dapat natin na gawin para maging pleasing ito sa Panginoon ang ating worship? Okay, so for Jesus, our worship should be pleasing in the eyes of God. Yun yung gusto ng mangyari ng Panginoong Jesus, no, sa ating pagsamba sa Panginoon, sa ating Diyos, na magiging pleasing ito sa kanyang harapan. And that this relational conflict should be dealt with one another. Dapat kung merong a worship that pleases God should know how to make resolution or reconciliation when there are conflicts, no, na mangyayari sa loob ng panambahan. This should be dealt with humility and with love for one another, so that there would be unity and harmony among the body of Christ or inside the church. And this what makes God pleased in our worship. Kapag nagkaroon po, meron po tayong unity, may pagkakaisa, no? Kapag ang conflict ay na-solve po natin, na-restore, when there's reconciliation, restoration of relationship from one another, okay? Doon po nalulugod ang Panginoon sa ating pag-worship, pagsamba. We need to be reconciled to one another to the one who have grudges against us, no? Kailangan daw po talaga tayong makipag-ayos, no? Makareconcile sa isang tao na mayroong grudges against us. We are not to hold these grudges nor to prolong it. holding grudges actually is a sin, no? As well as unforgiving spirit, it is also sin. We need to settle whatever grudges we have with someone. Kaya nga sabi ni Jesus Christ dito, leave your sacrifice at the altar and be reconciled to the person who has grudges against you. Okay? Before you offer your sacrifice or offering to the altar of God, leave it first. If you have sensed that there's someone who have something against you, no, then go back again after you are reconciled. Okay? Go back again and offer your sacrifice for that would please God with your worship, with your offering, no? So, simple instruction but hard to follow for many of us, no? Yan po ang ano, katotohanan. Very simple instruction but it's very hard for many of us to follow. You know, because for one, to do this kind of act, it takes humility. No, kailangan kasi ito ng pagpakumbaba at saka sincere na pagmamahal sa ating mga kapatid. Now, kung wala po tayong pagpapakumbaba at sincerong pagmamahal sa ating kapwa, ay mahirapan po tayong makipag-reconcile sa mga sa tao na nakapanakit sa atin or sa tao na nasaktan natin. No, we cannot do this without humility and without sincere love for one another. Our enemy here is actually ourself, no? Yun talaga ang ating kalaban dito. Ourself and our pride. As a result of this unresolved conflict, kung nangunguna to, nangingibabaw, no? Nangingibabaw po ang ating pong sarili, ang ating pong ang atin pong pride sa ating sarili ay it will result to a big problem, no, sa ating pag-worship. This unresolved relational conflict, the body of Christ will actually suffer, no? It will suffer yung body of Christ. The Holy Spirit also is grieved and that God is not pleased with our worship. Kaya seryoso ni siya, no? Na ano na issue na gi-raise ni Jesus Christ. Mura lang siya gamay mga part diri sa teaching but very ano to, important sa atin because it's really hard to do this, no? Kapag tayo po ay nasa ganitong sitwasyon na sa panambahan, tayo ay nag-worship sa Panginoon and that alam natin na meron tayong kapatiran na merong sama ng loob sa atin, no? Ramdam natin 'yan sa ating mga puso at isipan, no, na merong tao na may sama ng loob sa atin. And that even with that, sometimes we just ignore it, no? And that we continue to perform religiously, yung spiritually, yung ano natin, neglecting to reconcile the person who have something against us, who have grudges against us. Kasi nga, nangingibabaw talaga doon yung sarili natin and even yung pride natin. No? Yun yung pinakakalaban natin talaga dito when it comes to reconciliation. And that, you know, grudges are like COVID-19, no? They spread rapidly. It affects other people and that people also could recognize this sa ating life. We can also harm other people with our actions. Ang isang tao na sugatan, isang tao na merong hinanakit sa puso, no, ay pwede maaari din siya makapanakit ng ibang tao. Pwede ring maging ano siya, very touchy, no, sensitive. Madaling magalit. Okay? So yan yung ano, it's like COVID-19. Grudges are like COVID-19. They spread rapidly. Before we recognize it, our hearts are already numb, no? Kapag atin itong pinagpaliban, no? Atin itong hinuhold yung mga grudges sa ating life. We cannot feel anymore the presence of God in our lives as we worship Him. Why? Because we neglect to be reconciled to someone who has grudges against us. And that is the very basic na ano step no sa ating pag-worship. Let us remember when we come to worship, no? Maganda tong i-check yung heart natin, evaluate natin. Lord, is there any person na merong Lord ako ang nasakitan, or is there any person who have grudges against me? And then if God would lead you to that specific person, no? Then you as a child of God, no? As a disciple, pray and remember to reconcile. Yun yung goal mo, to be reconciled. Okay? It doesn't matter kung ikaw yung naka-open or ikaw yung na-open, no? Kasi yung sinabi lang dito, walang ano eh. Basta sinabi lang talaga dito, Jesus told us, no? Teach us that as you offer your sacrifices or offering to God, to the altar, and if you sin someone who grudges against you, leave your offering and be reconciled first, and then go back again, no, to offer your offering to God. For that would please our God, no, sa kanyang attitude. Now, let us remember that this the setting here is inside the church, and so we can assume here that this teaching directly points to all of us Christians in the church. Okay? It directs to you and me. Okay? It points to you and me. So, like you, I'm also guilty of this kind of sin. There are times when I'm aware that there's someone who has grudges against me, but instead of humbling myself, I just justify my actions and point at someone of their mistakes, no? Sabihin, why should I go and be reconciled with that person? Siya naman yung may mali, no? Siya naman yung may kasalanan. Bakit ako yung mag-ano doon, makipag-reconcile sa kanya? Siya dapat yung lumapit sa akin. Eh yung na-open mo, ganun din yung kanyang isipin, no? Ba't ako makipag-ano sa kanya? Siya yung may ano eh, problema. No? Kaya nga, pag ganun ang pareho yung kaisipan ng dalawang tao na puro nagpapataasan, walang nagpapakumbaba, talagang walang mangyayari, no? There's no reconciliation, and that it will lead to devastation, no, sa relationship pag matagalan. Kasi nga pag napupuno to, para nga sabi natin kanina, para po itong sang COVID-19 that it will affect, no, people, it will spread its virus. Kaya napakahirap po ng hindi po tayo nagpakumbaba, hindi po tayo gumagawa ng reconciliation kapag meron po tayong taong na nasaktan or nakapanakit sa atin. Mahirap po talagang makipag-ayos, no, sa ano, sa relationship. Ito yung pinaka ano din eh, pinaka challenging talaga sa ating life as Christians. But this keeps us mature, no, sa ating ano, sa ating pong paglalakad bilang mga disciple ni Christ. Arang sa ano din yan eh, apply natin sa ating buhay, no, sa mga married dyan, mga couple. Very often na tayo ay nagkakaroon talaga ng mga ano, no, misunderstanding, mga differences sa ating ano, and that sometimes it's really hard pag merong mga ganitong conflict, no, na ano, sa ating sa mag-asawa. Mahirap magkaayos. Buti na lang, ito nga yung ano natin is na tinuturuan tayo ng salita ng Diyos bilang mga Kristiyano, at meron tayong guidelines, no, na pwede nating pag-isipan na kapag naharap tayo sa ganitong sitwasyon ay kailangan gawin lang natin, i-obey lang natin yung ano ng Panginoon command, no, to be reconciled regardless of ano, sino yung may kasalanan or ikaw yung nasaktan. We must make an initiative as a Christian, as a disciple of Christ. Sabi ko nga kanina, ang hirap talaga dito kasi ang kalaban natin, yung sarili natin, and then yung pride. But God is not pleased when we are ano, holding that pride in us, no? Pag hindi po tayo nagpapakumbaba. So, we cannot please God in our worship if we do not reconcile, be reconciled, if we hold grudges against one another. If we don't reconcile with the person na mayroong grudges sa atin, no love, no humility equals to pride, no? The thing that I and we need to repent from, to repent and ask God for forgiveness on this. Kaya tayong lahat ay guilty nitong ano, ganito na pagdating dito na aspect when we fail to humble ourselves, no? And that we hold on to the grudges. Maraming mga ganitong mga problems, no? Even sa church, anywhere, no? Walang perfect na church. And that even very mature Christians, mga bishops, nag-away-away pa yan, no? Mga kailang mga bishops nga, nag-away-away gihapon. Walay reconciliation. Even anointed people, no? Pastors, mga malalaking congregation, may mga kaaway. At minsan talaga, di-discern mo, no? Kasi lumalabas sa, ano eh, every time when they speak, no? Their sermon, lumalabas sa kanilang bunganga, yung ano, yung nasa puso. And tatanong ka nga, no? Itong word, Lord, mukhang kailangan namin ng seriousness dito, no? Kailangan po naming lumago dito. We need to grow in this area. Kasi nga, kailangan talaga namin mapagkumbaba eh, na kaugalian eh. Maraming kakalungkot yung mga churches na ganito, no? Na walang settlement, walang maayos na reconciliation kapag nagkaka-problema. Ay natitipon yung ano, yung mga galit. So konting ano lang, konting mga kumbaga sa Bisaya, bikil-bikil lang gamay ba. Away dayon mga init kaayog ulo, no? Murag sa Immanuel man yata to. No? Murag ingana ang atong church, no? Sa ilo ako, murag ingana jud. Naingana jud ang atong church igsoon sa kadugay na natong pagpangalagad, no? And the sad thing is that kana lang naghag mga relasyon ato ang mga kaigsuunan nga wala na kuan ba, wala na heal, no? Walay closure, walay maayos na pagka-restore. Okay? Pataasay na lang, no, sa iri mga kuan. And that God is not pleased, the church suffer, the Holy Spirit is grieved. And that God is not pleased with our worship when we have that kind of attitude as we worship together as a body of Christ. So nakakalungkot yung ganun. Baka nga siguro ganun. Lord, why is it that our worship is very dry? Why is it, Lord, na yung aking prayer life napaka-dry, Panginoon? Pagbabasa ko ng Bible, parang wala. Why? Because there's something eh, that you did not obey. Baka yan yun eh. No? Bakit di ako parang may curse sa buhay ko, Panginoon? Hindi ako makaka-move on. Hindi ako mag-grow. Why? Because you neglect to obey the first step. That is to release forgiveness, to humble yourself, to be reconciled with someone, to people who have something against you, something or grudges against you. If you know those people, no? Person, there's still time, mga kapatid. Remember the model of Jesus Christ. He's the one who modeled us with this ano, reconciliation. He's the Son of God, the King of Kings, who sat on the throne. Anong ginawa ng Panginoon? For the sake of reconciliation and love for us, no? He sacrificed His position. He sacrificed His life. He humbled Himself for us to be reconciled by our Father, our God. So Jesus Christ sets us the example here. Hindi lang siya nagtuturo. Siya din ay talagang pinakita niya sa atin that He is the leading, the example for this reconciliation. Let us also be a vessel of this reconciliation, mga kapatid. Let us grow in this area. Because God is pleased in our worship as a church if we learn this spirit of forgiveness, spirit of humility and reconciliation with one another. So kung imuhang ninumduman karon to mga tao, no, na mga tan-aw nimo nga murag naa diay mga kahilugot-gut ug kasuko gihapon sa imong igsuon, wala jud nimo closure, wala mo nimo na settle. There's still time, no. Ikaw man siguro mo abot ang Ginoo ugma or next week. There's still time. The first step is pray. Pray to the Lord. And take initiative. Okay? Take initiative to do that. Why? Bakit natin gagawin yan na tayo ang mauna? Because we love our brother and sister. No? We love them. We are a family. Ayaw nating magkasiraan yung ano natin. God also seeks for this kind of love in our life. You know, that this is very a hard step to make as we obey Jesus in this area. But remember the blessing when we obey Him. Remember the blessing. First, ano yung ating ano? Anong blessing na ating makukuha? God is pleased with our worship when we offered at His altar. When we seek reconciliation with those who have grudges, who have something against us, God is pleased with our worship when we offer at His altar. Second, it gives us peace and joy as we worship Him. No? As we serve Him, it gives us joy. Lami kay igsuon nga mag-worship sa Ginoo, no? Mga langgad nga kanang walay mga kuan, walay kahiligot-got, no? Wala kay mga dalanga kabug-aton, no? Sa imuhang dughan ug sa imong nahuna, no? Naay peace, naay joy sa imong pangpangalagad. Thirdly, the body of Christ also is strengthened. Okay? Of course, when we are united, the body of Christ is strengthened together. No? Ang lihok sa kaaway, dili makakuan sa tuwa, makatandog kay tungod, anaa ang gugma sa sulod, no? Sa lawas ni Kristo. Nakita dito ang marka, no? Sa atong paghiligugmaay. Mokan na ang pinaka-powerful, no? Na ano natin, tool as a body of Christ to love one another. And if we reconciled, willing to reconcile with person, we show and display the love of God to us. And fourth, this also signifies that we are disciples of Christ as we show our love for one another, as we humble one another. No? So, let us be reconciled, no, to someone who have against us. We have remember, kung meron tayo ma-remember ng mga tao na dugay na kayo, tanawin mo, adyot miya to nag-settle ba, murag bugat gihapon kaya mong dughan pag magkita mi, no? Friends, there's still time, no? And you will see, no, the benefit of this when there is restoration and reconciliation with the relationships. Gwapo kayo, so nakita yun ni mo ang kuan sa Ginoo, no? Ang gugma sa Ginoo sa atong kinabuhi. And that you will see, no? Mugaan yun ang imuhang dughan. And that lami kayo mga lagad ngayong ana, no? And that sana, no, the Lord will guide us, will show to us what to do when we are in this situation na may mga conflicts sa relationship that is very normal sa atin as a church, even in our family, no, sa ating relationship, sa ating mag-asawa, sa mga anak, no. Let us learn from this and let us apply the principle to be reconciled, to humble ourselves, to love one another, and to sacrifice, no? Because we are family of God. Let us come to the Lord in prayer. Our gracious and loving Father, we thank you, Lord, that you are the one who first reached us and who saved us. You modeled to us, Lord, how you reconciled, you modeled to us this reconciliation, and how you reconcile us to God. Even if we are the one who offended you and who hurt you, Panginoon, kami po ang nakapanakit sa iyo because as we indulge in our sins, but Lord, you still choose to reach us out. You are full of grace, O God, full of humility and of love. And that is our prayer, Lord, as your people. Teach us also to become like you, to be humble and to love one another, as we worship you. And may you make our worship as a pleasing in your sight. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Join me in singing this song, Heart of Worship.
When the music fades, all is stripped away, and I simply come, longing just to bring something that's of worth, that will bless your heart. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear. You're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I've made it. When it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus. King of endless worth, no one could express how much you deserve. Though I'm weak and poor, every single breath. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear. You're looking into my heart. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I made. When it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus. I'm coming back to the heart of worship. Cause it's all about you, it's all about you. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I've made. Yeah, it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. All about you.
Praise the Lord. Indeed, the heart of worship is God and God alone. No? So for tonight, as we come to God in prayer, let us remember that it's all about God, and that may God be glorified, no, in our midst, regardless of our situation in this life, regardless of these uncertainties, no, na ating kinakaharap ngayon, itong pandemic. Let God be glorified pa rin, no, sa ating life as we come to Him. Then, this time, let us now devote our time in prayer. Okay, if you have seen in our screen, that's our prayer focus. Yung una natin, papanalangin yung ating pong gobyerno. Let's pray for our government, our nation. Of course, yung mga general concerns and special requests, no, na meron tayo. binigay sa atin ng mga kapatiran. Okay? Okay, let us pray po natin yung ating sa government, yung ating president and the rest of the government officials. So let us come together before the Lord and let us pray together. Hallelujah. Salamat po Panginoon for this time that we can lift up to you, O God, ang amin pong mga namumuno po sa aming pamahalaan. And that Lord, nang una amin pong tinataas po sa inyo ang amin pong presidente. We pray for our president that he will intimately know, O God, Lord, the real Jesus. Makilala po niya, Panginoon, si Jesus Christ sa kanyang life. And that he will fully, O God, Lord, surrender his life to you. We pray, O God, na ikaw po, Panginoon, ang kumilos, Panginoon, at humipo sa kanyang puso. And that we pray that you will use an instrument, O God, to bless him with your word, to bless him with the good news. Alam po namin na wala pong imposible sa inyo, Panginoon. Even the kings, O God, Lord, submit to you and surrender their lives to you. So we also pray for our president. We pray, O God, that may you touch his heart and that he will also, Lord, come to trust in you and follow you, Panginoon, sa kanyang buhay. We pray also for wisdom and discernment for each decision na kanya pong ginagawa sa kanya pong sa aming pong bansa. Mahirap po, Panginoon, ang mga problema ng aming bansa, and that very crucial, Panginoon, ang every decision making na kanyang ginagawa. So we just pray for wisdom and discernment, Panginoon, sa lahat po ng kanyang ginagawa, O God, and that lead him to the right path, Panginoon. Pray for good health also for him, protection from all forms of harm. Napaka-vulnerable din po ng aming presidente sa kinakaharap na pandemic COVID-19, Panginoon. And that we pray for him na may protect him from all the disease, Panginoon, tong COVID-19. From any harms, from any threat, O God, Lord, of weak, evil people. Protect him, we pray. We pray also for the rest of the government officials, that they too also, Lord, may know the Lord Jesus Christ and may surrender their lives to you. Lord, we pray that ikaw po, Panginoon, ang maging sentro, Panginoon, center, mangunguna sa kanila pong mga buhay, sa kanila pong mga ginagawa, even sa kanilang families. We pray that, Lord, may you remind them always, Lord, to do what is right as a politician, as a servant of God, Lord, of this government. Give them a heart, a purple heart, to follow what is right and what is just, O God, Lord, sa kanila pong mga ginagawa. Panginoon, enlighten them with the truth, enlighten them with your word, and that, Panginoon, salamat po sa iyo pong pangunguna sa amin pong mga government officials. We do believe that ikaw po ang nag-install sa kanilang mga specific positions in our government, and that, Lord, it is our prayer that may you continue to guide them, you continue to protect them, may you continue to give them wisdom, Panginoon, sa kanila pong mga ginagawa. This we pray in Jesus' name. Protection also, Lord, provision in the face of ongoing pandemic. We pray for sa amin pong bansa. Patuloy po kaming lumalaban itong COVID-19. At napakahirap po talaga nitong problemang ito. The whole world, O God, Lord, is struggling, O God, up to this time on how we could survive, we could stand, O God, on this challenge. Very challenging time, but we do believe that you are with us, Lord. You will help us. You will deliver us from this pandemic crisis. For each Filipino, Panginoon, dalangin ito naman namin to love the country by obeying the law, respecting one another, and being responsible citizens that contribute to a better society. Bawat isa po sa amin, Panginoon, gamitin mo po kami na maging responsible po kami na citizen. to cooperate with all the Lord, the law that given to us, Lord, guidelines given to us to Panginoon para po namin ma-listen ito pong sakit ng COVID-19. We pray for the Philippines to become a godly nation that fears, obey, and love God. We pray also for the gospel to be freely proclaimed throughout the country. Tulungan mo po kami, Panginoon, in the midst of this pandemic that we can still propagate, Lord, and share the good news of your gospel to those people who need it, who need your word. Salamat po, Panginoon. For our general concerns, we pray, O God, for the sick and infected people. O God, will you heal and help them, O Lord, sustain their bodies and spirits, contain the spread of the infection, yung mga meron pong infected, Panginoon, na mga tao, itong sakit, COVID-19. We pray that may you help them recover, strengthen their immune system. Be with them, O God, we pray. For our vulnerable populations, we pray for our elderly and to those suffering from chronic disease. Lord, we pray for them right now. May you be with them, guide them, and comfort them, Lord, with your love. Comfort them with your word. Encourage them, O God, in the midst of these challenging times. Provide also for the poor, especially to the uninsured. For the young ones and the strong, God, give them the necessary caution to keep them from unwittingly spreading this disease and inspire them to help to become a solution, Lord, to the problem. Tulungan mo po ang amin po mga kabataan na sila po ay magiging responsable din po, Panginoon, na citizen, that they will do their part to become a solution to the problem for this crisis we are facing. Panginoon, tulungan mo po mga kabataan namin even as they now continue, Lord, with their online studies. Ka po mauna sa kanila, Panginoon. For our local governments, God, help our elected officials as they allocate the necessary resources for combating this pandemic. Help them provide more tests, provision po, Panginoon, financial provisions din. And even, Lord, we pray for those wicked people who tampered, O God, Lord, yung mga results, who are doing wicked things, O God, just to profit for themselves. And that we pray that may you intervene on this, na mahuli po yung mga taong ito na namimiki po ng result ng COVID test. And that nalalagay po sa panganib ang amin pong mga mamamayan with this, Lord. Tulungan mo po ang aming mababatas, our policemen, to look unto these people, O God. And we pray for our scientific community, leading the charge to understand the disease and communicate its gravity. God, give them knowledge, give them wisdom, and persuasive voice. For the media, committed to providing up-to-date information, God, help them to communicate with appropriate seriousness, without causing panic, telling the truth, Lord, with their news. We also pray for those with mental health challenges who feel isolated today, right now, anxious and also helpless. God, provide them every necessary support. And, tulungan mo po, Panginoon, ng mga tao ngayon na nakaramdam ng mga ganitong Lord, kabigatan sa pag-iisip because of this, the challenge that we are facing. Lord, tulungan mo po sa sila. May you have mercy upon them, Lord. For the homeless, unable to practice the protocols of social distancing, protect them from disease, and provide isolation shelters in every city. Tulungan mo po, Panginoon, ang aming pong pamahalaan, our city government, to, Lord, strictly, O God, Lord, implement yung pong pag-isolate talaga nitong mga tao na naan doon sa lansangan. And that, Lord, you provide for the needs of our city government to shelter of these people and the protection, Panginoon, sa kanila. For the stranded individuals, God helped them to return home safely and quickly. Napakahirap po ng sitwasyon po ng aming mga LSIs ngayon, dumadami po. And that, Panginoon, have mercy, nalagay po sa peligro ang aming po mga kababayan as they, Lord, shelter in one place, O God, Lord, and that they could not perform any, Lord, safety protocols na, Panginoon, doon po sa lugar na siksikan. So, Lord, have mercy, God, Lord. Help our government to make solution to this quickly. For Christian missionaries also, Lord, throughout the world, God, provide them with words of hope and equip them to love and serve those around them. For workers in variety of industries who have been and are facing layoffs and financial hardships, God, keep them from panic and inspire your church to generously support them. For families with young children at home, for the foreseeable future, God, help the mothers and the fathers to partner together creatively for the care and nurture of their children. For single mothers and fathers, grow their networks of support. Help them, Lord, give them wisdom. For parents who cannot stay home from work but must find care for their children, God, present them with creative solutions. For those in need of regular therapies and treatments, Lord, help them to stay patient and positive. For business leaders making difficult decisions that affect the lives of their employees, God, give them wisdom and help them to lead self-sacrificially. For pastors and church leaders faced with challenges of social distancing, God, help them to creatively imagine how to pastor their congregants and love their cities as well. For students whose courses of study are changing, show them, Lord, that while life is uncertain, their trust should be in you. For Christians in every neighborhood, community, and city, may your Holy Spirit inspire us to pray, to give, to love, to serve, and to protect, proclaim the gospel, and that the name of Jesus Christ might be glorified around the world. For those who lost their loved ones and are grieving, Lord, give them strength and extend your loving comfort toward them. For frontliners, workers, healthcare, police force, we thank you for their vocational call to serve us. We pray that may you keep them safe and healthy. Keep their families, Lord, safe and healthy. Panginoon, protect them. Help them to be knowledgeable about this disease and as well as the changing protocols. Help them to stay clear-minded in the midst of surrounding panic. For our frontliners workers, we thank you for their vocational call to serve as we pray. Deliver them from anxiety, from their own loved ones, aging parents, children, spouses, roommates. Give them compassion, Lord, for every person they serve under care. Provide for them financially, especially if they fall ill and are unable to work. Help Christian frontliners also to exhibit extraordinary peace so that many would ask about the reason for their hope, and that, Lord, may you give them opportunities to proclaim the gospel in Jesus' name. For our specific requests, meron po tayong mga requests na prayers sa ating mga kapatiran. Pinadala po sa atin pong mobile phone. Okay, we would like to lift up the sister of Ate Leonie Mayano, who is right now in Luzon. Her sister, Teresita Gaspar, is now suffering from stage 4 cancer. O Lord, we pray for your mercy. We pray for your, Lord, encouragement upon this sister of ours, Panginoon. Saan man po siya ngayon, you know her. And that we pray for your, Lord, strength be upon her, O God. And that may your favor rest upon her. Tulungan mo po siya, Panginoon, to trust in you. And that to really hope in you alone. Whatever may happen, Panginoon, that she will, Lord, rest her faith in you alone. Salamat po, Panginoon, that it is you're willing, O God, to heal this person. Lord, we entrust him to you for healing, O God, Lord, sa kanya. We pray also for Peter Blair Agustin, who just, Lord, discharged from the hospital. Sa kanya pong patuloy na treatment, we pray, O God, for healing upon him, and that may you encourage him always with your word. Pray that may you strengthen him, O God, Lord, physically, spiritually, even emotionally. For our frontliners, doctors, we'd like to lift up to you, Panginoon, sila Dr. Karen Pabila, Dr. Libre, Max, Nixie, Dr. Sam. Ingatan mo po, Panginoon, ang mga doctors, si Dr. Winky Suklan, Dr. Ana Pareño, Dr. Marilyn Nabalis, sa kanila pong araw-araw na pag-report po sa kanila pong mga designated po na mga assignments. Lord, very exposed po mga taong ito sa hospital. We pray for your protection upon them, Lord. We pray for your provision. We pray for your encouragement from them. And that tulungan mo po sila to perform effectively, Lord, as a doctor, and help more people with their skills. We pray for our nurses as well, sa sila Scott Carmen, Anna Marie Eckert, Noong Payot. Panginoon, we lift them up to you, protect them as well. We pray, O God, Lord, for your protection and provision from them, and encourage them always, Lord, with your word, we pray. Okay, so yun po ang ating pong mga prayer items so far. If you have remember something, no, na mga urgent na prayer requests, don't forget to text, no, with our number, prayer number, and that send it to us so that we can pray together, no, sa ano. Ito po yung number natin, no, sa okay, mobile number 0922-29-26480. Okay, if you have your prayer request pa, so that we can pray together. So, daghang kayong salamat sa ato ang tanan, no, sa ato ang mga pag-ampo, magapadayon kita pag-ampo igsoon, sa ato ang nasod, no, sa ato ang mga pamilya, sa ato ang mga kaigsoonan karon nga grabe po na apektuhan, no. Let's be an encouragement, let's be a blessing to them, no, and that magapadayon din kita na mag-aampo sa atong sitwasyon. We do believe that God's deliverance is on its way, no. Din kita kalimtan sa Ginoo, di kita pasagdan sa atong Ginoo igsoon. Okay, so mayong gabi sa tanan, let us come together in prayer. Let us pray. Maraming salamat po, Lord, for this night as we come together to pray as a body of Christ, as a family, and that we continue to pray our nation, our country, our families, Lord, our economy. Panginoon, tulungan mo po ang aming bansa, ang aming pong presidente, kami pong lahat, Panginoon, that we can adjust and survive to this with this crisis. And that we do believe, Lord, that you are with us on this. Tulungan mo po ang aming mga mamayan, lahat po na mga affected, Lord, naghihirap, Panginoon, na wala ng mga trabaho, mga businesses. Lord, be with them, have mercy, O God. Salamat po, Panginoon, that there is hope in you when we look up to you, O God. And that salamat sa iyo pong mensahe, namin pong napakinggan, encouraging us, Lord, to love our brothers and sisters, to humble ourselves, and to worship you, to please you, Lord, in our worship. May the love of the Father and the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be upon us, both now and forevermore. And the people of God will say, Amen and Amen. God bless us and good night. Ayo-ayo mga igsoon, take care. See you again next Sunday. Thank you.